remembering death and the grave, and remember Allah Azza wa Jalla, that you will stand in front of Him one day. This cures weakness of iman, trust me. I started giving lectures about the grave recently, and the more I give lectures on the grave, the more I hate everything I own. The more I despise this dunya, the more I'm satisfied with pretty much anything that comes in front of my path. Because what you realize is that you're going to be put in the ground, and you're not taking any of it with you. The only thing, the only currency of the akhirah is deeds. When you reach that grave, it's almost as if there's a sign there that nothing beyond this point except عَامَلَ الصَّالِحِ. Nothing behind there except the good deeds that you've done, or the bad deeds that you have done. That's the only thing you can take beyond that point. So dragging all this dunya around with you, it's not going to be yours anymore. We must remember death. The Prophet ﷺ said, remember often the destroyer of pleasures. Remember often the destroyer of pleasures. And what is the destroyer of pleasures? Death. Death. Death is going to destroy all that which you covet of this life. When you finally are at your death, you're going to take one final look at this world, and unfortunately, it's going to be the moment most of us realize how feeble this dunya is, when we're about to leave it. When we're taking our last look at this world, we will realize this world is nothing. Nothing. We will realize how feeble it is. But the people who are blessed are people who realize that before death. The Prophet ﷺ said about this dunya, that once he was walking with his companions, and there was a dead carcass on the side of the road that was deformed. And he picked it up. It had little ears, it was deformed. He picked it up. And he said, which one of you will buy this from me for a dinar? They said, Ya Rasulullah, we wouldn't even take it if you gave it to us for free. We would not even take this dead, stinking, deformed carcass from you if it was free. He said, then know that the world and everything it contains, all its glitz and glamour and gold and wealth and status and money and fame and fortune, he said, all of it to Allah is more despised than this carcass is despised in your eyes. It means nothing. On the day of judgment, Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to roll it all up. The heavens and the earth, Allah is going to roll it up and hold it in His hand and say, we're the kings of the earth today. The people who used to fight each other and kill each other and strive and do so much injustice over this silly dunya, where are you today? When I've rolled all of this up like it's nothing. Do you not realize it was nothing? Unfortunately, we won't realize that fact until we don't have it anymore. And you know the one thing that I guarantee you, one of our salaf said, by Allah, every single son of Adam will regret every single moment they did not spend remembering Allah. Every moment you did not spend remembering Allah, you will truly despise it and regret it. We have to remember that we're leaving this dunya. We can't take any of it with us. We will regret. When the angel of death comes to them, they cry out, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, irji'un, send me back. Irji'un, send me back. Why? Why do they want to go back? Do they want to go back to pray? La. Do they want to go back to see their family? Do they want to go? No. لَعَالِي أَعْمِلَ صَالِحَا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ So that I can go do some good with that which I left behind. So that which I left behind, I can go back and get it and do some good with it. Let us not be of those people, inshaAllah ta'ala. Let us do the good that we have while it's in front of us. And let us avoid the evil that is in front of us while we're here.